Aha! Now we can clean experiments. I'd much rather have an actual Kermit out there, like, scrubbing it with a cloth. But that's pretty cool. So that means we can do mystery goo as well. And we can just sort of hang out here, sciencing. Whoa. It instantly did it, I guess. We can send you off, and I don't care about the breaking. I'll fix it with a washcloth. We also have some other sciencey things. Temperature? What temperature is it on Minmus? Ooh, we can even science that some. And that won't break, I don't think. Man, we're getting mad sciences out here. Angry, upset, totally irrelevant sciences. Aw. There's no atmosphere to measure. Dag nerbit. So what about you, Cybro? Are you cleaned? Cool. So now we can redo the thing and get no science from it. I guess we'll keep this because we're going to take it home. But we did get some science from doing that. And we can also do this mystery goo and improve and keep it. This one's done. So I guess the idea behind this would be to be able to move it now and then do more processing later. I don't really see the benefits still, but I could be wrong. I was once, a long, long time ago, long before. Quink. Alright, so we will take a surface, surface sample. No flag planting today. I will keep you, and we'll take an EVA report, because we've not been to the Minmus Midlands, apparently. So now we've got that covered. And I've heard, I think this is true, I think you get a different EVA report from the latter. So I think if I take this up and store the data in the command module, and then get back on the ladder, we're going to need to use the RC rocket boosters to get up here anyway. Hey, rockets. Thank you. I don't know why I was bothering with the friggin' ladder. Okay, so if we go in here, that'll load all the stuff into the ship, and we can go back out and grab the ladder, and I think we'll get a different EVA. Nope. Apparently not. Oh, we're in space just above the Midlands, but apparently we've already got that data. Fine. Alright, so I guess now that means that this is dunsies. And what we need to do is the tug part of the experiment, which is going to be really fucking hard. We have to get the other two up in the command module, separate it. It's going to sit there, in theory. How do I get them out of there? Whoa! Yeah, I have no idea how to get them out. Oh, wait, I have to click on the door. There we go. No. That. There we go. Got it. Aw. Now I'm getting confused. But yeah, I just gotta pull them out of here. Hopefully they'll let go of the ladder. Fly up, get in. Zoop. Fly up, get in. Vacuum in. And I'm not gonna blow the top. Well, let's see what happens. Oh, please don't go anywhere. Okay. Alright, we're good. Now we can open the shield and wait for rescue. Oh man, this is a bad idea. Anyway, I could have just launched this up, but that's not the point. I want to see if it's possible for us to pick this up with the lifter. It's going to be very difficult and could require a serious rescue mission later if and when we fuck this up. But it could be awesome if we can just swoop in and grab it and then go. You know? Awesome, right? Alright, got all our fuel, got everything looking good. Let us undock and be about our business. Excuse me, I have places to be, people to go. We're gonna have to make a exacting landing maneuver as well, which is a bit weird. Also, I forgot I have no torque. Twerk. Problems for the future landers of America society, but this is the one we have. Why am I floating this way? That's not good. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and plan a maneuver for this where we can actually hope to try and hit the right spot. Nope, that's not gonna be possible because the planet is gonna be rotating. So how about, I'm gonna go with the flow for a little bit and see if I can get to a point where the planet and we are in a similar facing sort of here, and now I should be able to do this, and in theory, in the future, in the time that we get there, this will be over there. That's what I'm going to go with. In fact, I'm just going to do the burn now. This is so wrong. I don't know what I'm doing. Help. Send help. Okay. Okay. It's working. It's working. The planet's rotating. I'm falling. And... Okay. Maybe not perfect. But close-ish. I think we're going to need to do a... slow the fuck our horizontalness down burn. Technical term, again, as usual. Should be somewhere right around here, using lots of RCS in bat. Whoa. That is the exact opposite of the way that I wanted to burn. As is the huge. Oh, me. As long as we can get it somewhere around in a circle near it, we should be okay. There we go. Oh, man, I really wish this thing had some sort of control over itself. So much for that whole circle around it thing. We're gonna be lined up with it pretty well, but... other than that, things aren't looking so hot. Other than the whole... lining up part. So let's see here. We need to... burn this way? No, we need to burn this way. Getting warmer. Yes, we need to burn to the north so that we can come nearer to it. Yes, look at that. Look at that. I accidentally did it right on purpose. Are we going to hope that that drops us in the right spot, or are we going to do it by hand? I think I'm going to try to influence the outcome here by doing a retro burn that will be beneficial to our Apple... Perry sauce sustenance program Kerbal. I don't know what I'm doing. Send help! Did it just fucking move? It looked like it moved. Okay, that might land us near where we want to be. I don't know. Who fucking knows? Maybe that's why people don't do this tugboat system, is because it's really fucking hard to rendezvous with something on the ground. Oh, hey. We're damn near gonna hit it. Okay, we're definitely going to hit it, because we're going to try really hard to hit it. But for now, we've got to slow our roll a bit. Come on. Get over there. Opposite of Scorpion. Okay, maybe we won't hit it. Maybe I shouldn't have done that burn. I think I know how to make up for it, though. We can just burn sort of like this. Yes. Yes. Correct my mistakes. Corrections. Alright. Now we're going for it. In fact, what I can do, I think, is maybe set this as a target. And then that'll show up. Yeah. Okay, so what we need to do now then is... yeah, we're just going to do a super high-speed docking maneuver. With a object on the surface of a planet. Standard astronaut stuff. This is they practically teach this at astronaut daycare. Which I clearly did not attend. Okay, so according to my balls, we're gonna hit it. And I trust my balls. This one anyway, my uniball. Whether or not this is going to be good for us in the long run, I don't know. In fact, I have no idea what I'm doing. Oh, man. I hope that thing works. Oh, I'm going to need to use RCS just to try to get control of this fucking thing. Okay, we need to move a smidgen. Oh, we need to slow down a lot, actually. Why did my nav ball just get all crazy? Nav balls. I trusted you. Whoop. Okay, that's theoretically dead on. Wow, Fraps actually crashed before we did. Early bird gets the worm, I guess. Okay, we've lost our target lock. But that's okay. Alright, now I'm going to need to kick on the RCS and really get myself scooted over there. So I want to target the Clampotron if I can. There should be a Clampotron Clampo on there, but I can't find it for the life of me. If we can't find that Clampotron and target it, then that's pickles. I'm starting to get a better view. Aha! Okay. There we go. Now it's all easy business. Just don't hit it too fast, that's all. Oh my goodness, I'm gonna have to get rid of the nav ball to do this, I think. This was a bad idea. What have I done? Alright, fuck the nav ball. I can't believe I'm gonna try this. Oh shit, that's even reversed. We're gonna run out of RCS fuel so fast. Okay, Oh! Come on! Get it! Get in my space tugboat! Oh god, we did it! Holy shit. Wow. Okay, almost out of our monopropellant. Not good at all, because... Actually, we don't need to dock back with the space station, but we should, because we're going to burn a lot of fuel picking this bad mother up. Either way, here we go. I got you guys. You're coming with me in my tugboat. Close the shield. Hooray. It's a little bit precariously attached. I should probably figure out which direction I'm doing this burn, huh? Should be that way. Nope, it's the opposite of that way. Of course. Which way is the space station rotating? I think it's rotating this way. Yeah, okay, so we need to burn like so? He hoped out loud, fearing always for the worst. Yep, alright. We's on our way now. We's on our way. Good job, Team Kerbins. I'm gonna control from here, because my thing seems to be oddly pointed. There we go. Now everything's starting to make sense. It was controlling it from the cupola or whatever. And nobody wants that. Unless you like singing alone, also known as a cupola, huh? I'm so sorry. I can't help it. They just come out like it's a disease. Something's wrong. I can't. It's not stoppable. All right. So because of where we are launching from, I had to do a bit of a downy burn. Technical terms again. But we had to do a downy, not uppy burn in order to get our apple of goodness to be lined up with the green line of happiness. Yes. I'm just going to keep going until this goes out there somewhere. Come on, apple of goodness. Line up with the... There. Yes. Oh. The apple of goodness is trying to escape the green line of happiness. But we cannot let that happen. Alright. That's cool. Now I'm just gonna do some circularization and orbitalization burns. Yeah, like this. Whip. Zoop. And wow. Whoa! Not that button. I'm really... I'm a little bit torn on whether or not we should dock with this, because I don't think we need to, and it's not designed to, because we're gonna need to sacrifice this tugboat anyway, because the command module that the Kerblins are in ain't going anywhere on its own anyway. There's no damn fuel at all. So there's that. It has parachutes, but it has to get back to the atmosphere. So I'm thinking that's a 3-second burn to get us into the same orbit roughly as the space station. Or we could just do a burn like this and like this. How the hell would we go about doing this? I think we just launched from the wrong side of the planet. And yeah, we're gonna have to make an orbit anyway. Then we can figure out a way. So I think I will do that. Just say, fuck the space station. We're gonna try to get home without it. But if we happen to make an orbit that aligns with the space station, at least... yeah, we should do that. So it'll be theoretically possible for us to rendezvous with it, should we decide that we do not have enough fuel. That'll do. We just have to find our burn spot. Oh, it's nice that that cupola module thingy is attached now, because it means I can actually turn my thing. I can actually turn the ship. Calm down. Don't get ahead of yourself. We've got business to attend to. So, quick little 2-second burn here. Wow. What the hell? Are we gonna... no, we're not going fast enough. That's okay. Like I said, I don't think we need to intersect with it. I could maybe hit the gas right now and catch up to it, but... life is for the people who do things not because it's just correct, but because they're lazy and feel unobligated to do things correctly. You can just put that little gemstone of a quote on my grave tomb and call it a day. I'm having a really tough time with words right now. Ha! How about it? Let's do with science instead of words. Okay, so that's a 12-second burn. We should have enough fuel to get this sucker all the way back home. We'll just do this, and then we'll do another burn here. 12 seconds plus another probably 20-second burn there, maybe. Easy peasy. Lemmy squeezy. You're wheezy with my peasy. Yeezy. Okay, wait. I remember now. I remember the quote. That's... I got it wrong because my words are having problems today. But it is that we do this thing not because it is easy, but because it is for sheezy and awesome at the same time. Quote done. We're still a minute away from our burn marker, but it doesn't really matter. Let's just go, shall we? Enough of this science madness. I'm done with that. Fire the rockets. Put us at the place with the thing. How much fuel do we have left? Billions. That is an exact numeral unit. We have a billions of fuel. And now we're just going to do this. Periapsis. 3 bajillion. Nope. More like... hit the planetillion. Am I right? Look at me, I'm just wobbling all over the place. Fuck this shit. I think we're gonna hit the planet. Yep, probably. Cool. See, like, science is worthless. Look at what we did, just randomly burning in strange directions. Efficiency schmishency. We're going home. Well, that's a cool looking galaxebula. Let's crash into it someday. Oh, atmosphere, I hope you're working today. We desperately need your help. So the crane is going to die now. Ideally, you know, having this in a more reliable fashion, the crane would never die. But I wasn't happy with the layout of the crane anyway. It didn't perform completely to my expectations. We need to put more SAS on it and more RCS on it. But we know now that it's theoretically feasible. And it'll serve the dual purpose of getting our Kerman's home. I'm going to do a simulated retro burn, because the atmosphere is not going to kill us at this trajectory, but it should. So I'll just do this to make life seem a little bit less worthless. Until I manage to get my hands on the deadly reentry mod, which sounds like a euphemism for anal sex, but somehow isn't. At which point, the difficulty curve will ramp up significantly. And mostly I'm just burning off this fuel so that when we jettison it, I won't feel so bad about having wasted so much fuel. There's a little honesty for you. Enjoy. Oh! Ooh, I forgot about the golden rule. Never do time compression with the thrusters on. I'm gonna let it hit the atmosphere like this, though, because I really, really, really want to see it start burning like all this, and then watch the solar panels fly off. That's like one of my favorite things about Kerbal Space Program, so let's just sit back and enjoy the show. In fact, let's turn the SAS off and see how it wants to enter the atmosphere. It's gonna be a bit before we get there, but... Ooh, there we go. Free falling! Tom Petty up in this bitch. Goodbye, solar panels. Boom! Off they go. Man, this guy is decelerating rapidly. I suppose I should probably... Maybe I should flip upside down. No, let's undock this. And... Oops. You. Oh. Bad things are gonna happen when I deploy my parachutes if this thing is on top of me. Okay, thankfully it's getting out of our way. And we can wish it goodwill. Thanks for bringing us back, Tugboat. Peace. Now we gotta hope the parachutes hold. Bye, Tugbro. I'll see you on the other side. Yes. We've made it, but the Tugbro did not. Alright, so I feel like that's a good proof of concept for the Tugboat. Whether or not I'll ever need to do it, or anything like that, is to be seen. I'm also going to wrap up in this Jeff Special Mission Program the other part of the Minimus package, the Jet Rover, next, but this has been enough for this part. And we should get some good science from this. 420, research it. Okay. And got a little bit of money back, and we got our crew back, and we got to use a new module part. It cost us a lot of money, though. We're already down to 600 G's. That's okay. Money is meant to be spent. So I guess with the next part, we're going to try out alternative roving techniques, like the Minmo Jet Rover, which I really want to know how this is going to work, because it's got potential, I think. And if it works, we could theoretically milk all of the science ever out of Minmus. Sounds good to me.